Welcome Ratbags to part 2 of my 100 days, the complete and finished version. In the first part, we managed to build a giant massive mushroom fort to get ready for the Bug Strike back update, all done by pretty much day 50, alright, technically day 52. And you can go and check out that video to see every single day. Otherwise, I'm going to give you a quick recap of that first 50 days, then we're straight on to part 2. Can we beat Grounded in 100 days, defeating the big bosses like the Assistant Manager, the Termite King, and of course the Broodmother? My name's Jade, I cover Grounded, everything you need to know, gameplay, guides, news and more. Make sure you leave a like, check out the first 50 days as I said, and let's go with part 2, how to survive 100 days in Grounded. So of course day 1 we spawned in the backyard, shrunken down to smaller than a blade of grass. We quickly turned on the machine and we headed over to the oak tree after setting up a camp. We caught up with Burgle, got some quests and some indications about where to go next. Pretty much we had to go and turn the power on at the Hedge Laboratories, exploring, gaining new resources and a bunch of chips to get new technology. With the power turned on, I pretty much just survived. I hadn't played Grounded legit for a while, so it was good getting resources, crafting new gear, weapons and armour, and getting ourselves ready. By day 26, we were ready to explore one of the most dangerous laboratories in Grounded, the Haze. Exploding infected bugs absolutely everywhere. You don't want to come down here unless you've got some decent armour. Or, as it turns out, really good at cheesing creatures with a bow and arrow. We defeated the infected ladybug, and this would be power to laboratory number 2. By day 31, it was time to go and explore the picnic table properly and get some of the new unlocks and even more Mega Milks. By the time day 39 rolled, we were pretty prepared and it was time to go and take on the Black Ant Hill. Again, another challenging place, especially with the Assistant Manager as the boss fight. It's a huge winding network of tunnels to find him, but eventually we did, and we tried our best to take him out. This guy's pretty tough with all the electric traps and the laser beams, as well as his minions. I got absolutely ruined. All my armor pretty much broke, but we just about come in clutch and he was defeated. We got the vital upgrades we needed. Now we could go ahead and craft our mushroom build pieces. That was the whole point of the 50 days, to get prepared for the Bug Strike back update, a new one that would enable creatures and bugs to come and attack your base more regularly. So I had to get a mushroom fort up in time. Day 43 and we got one more chip from the sandbox. Grounded pros know all about this place, it's absolutely sizzling hot, so you normally need the right armor unless you're a super cheesy guy like me hiding in the shadows. With the chip acquired, we went and killed a bunch of the antlions that live here and we managed to craft a bunch of the antlion armor. This would give us the strength to go and get some of the charcoal pieces in the fallen barbecue zone. These were the main ingredients to get our cook on and start baking our mushroom bricks in our ovens. Me and this lava chilled out in the hot springs. It was pretty tough, but day 44 we managed to do it. We got a whole bunch of them, but the grind was on. Would we be able to get enough ovens going by getting boiling glands from bombardier beetles before day 50? These little green and yellow things love to play hide and seek, and it took a real effort to go and find all of them. But finally we did it, we had enough now to guarantee we'd cook enough mushroom bricks to build a substantial base ready for when the bugs strike. And we began building our spot right on one of the flower beds above, pretty close to the Frankenline, one of the best base spots you can find, and day 50 we started to build. We actually overran by about a day and a half, it was pretty much day 52 almost by the time I got the fort finished. But I was still really pleased with myself. I hadn't played Grounded properly for a good while, legit, and it was nice to know that I'd managed to get this far and build something pretty impressive. So that's the recap, now let's carry the journey on. So it was actually about 4 days I spent gathering more resources and dismantling our old base and taking it over to our new location and of course the brand new mushroom fort I'd built. You served me well this little spot, but yeah, I really love my new base location. Let me know your favourite base location in the comments down below. So with the new update, it did mean we have to go redo every single one of the labs I'd completed in the first 50 days. So it was back to the Hedge to kill more of the robots and get more stuff. For sure, it was a lot easier this time round, as I definitely had a lot better armour and weapons. That's it, Burgle, you put that chip in there. We can now go ahead and start upgrading our armour sets. And I bought some new cook recipes too. Day 58, we went back to base, prepared with some smoothies and consumables, it was time to go and do the Haze Laboratory. But this time, we'd be taking the back entrance.
And here we go. Through the exposed pipes, this is the other way that you can get into the Haze.
Once I escaped some wharf fleas, we were chased by a bell spider as I desperately tried to make my way through, get some special goodies, and then make it back with oxygen.
No! I've messed up, guys. I've totally messed this up. No! Oh, no!
A very soggy effing chat. Not to fear, we dived back in, we got the goodies, nice 500 science points, as well as a mega milk, and we made our way through the rest of the pipe till we got to the Haze Lab. Still definitely one of the toughest laboratories to do, the infected in here are OP.
Mate, I haven't got many arrows left, gotta get this right.
At times like this, I really wish I'd had a fresh minty weapon, as that's one of the best things to use against infected. We eventually made it through and it was just time to take out these dust mites before this laboratory was done. Then we had to survive getting home and not get blown up by even more infected ladybugs. On the way, only stopping for another mega milk, it'd soon be time to turn off the haze so we could explore and get a whole bunch of quartzite nice and easy. Chip number 2, my little burgle friend. Day 59, we prepared once more for another adventure, but before I dived into the pond, we decided to go and see if we could get some scarabs. These little critters are super speedy, so you got to hit them with a really high, powerful arrow from a crossbow. Or get super lucky and cheesy, when he literally couldn't run past the stick. We was going to need so many more of these to get our armors upgraded. Once that was done, it was time, our first hurrah into the water to go and get some more bits. We definitely needed some diving gear, and that's what I was hoping to get, the raw resources, so that we could explore the underwater pond lab. We took out the water fleas and we took out the water boatman. This would get us some flippers too. Flippers on and a breathing stick, we got another milk molar before heading back home and crafting the slime lantern. Never the best of times to go swimming at night, it was pretty cold and pretty dark, but we persevered and carried on. We went down the opposite end of the pond this time. There's another entrance with the T-Rex, but this time I wanted to explore and see what was here. We did eventually make it to the pond laboratory, and I quickly forgot that you needed to put your hand on the biometric scanner. This was part new, added in the last couple of updates. That's how long it's been since I was down in the pond. So I ain't gonna lie, I panicked a bit, swam around, looking for some sort of power button that just wasn't there, before eventually chat reminded me that yes, go back Jade and get your hand on that biometric scanner.
Ooh, can you imagine, failed straight away.
Now it was time to turn on the breakers once I clicked on the initial power. But I did have to deal with this sparky boy first. The peep features were just added where we could get cards from the creatures we killed, and I got a nice little gold one. Breaker number 1, done. Number 2, done. Number 3 was a bit tougher. It's got an air vent pushing air down this corridor, but I just about made it and we ignored the little scab and also the mega milk. It was really just about getting the power on this time. Number 3, done. All 3 breakers open, now it was time to go into the pond lab proper. The Murti mutation also unlocked. I spend so little time in the water, I don't even know what it's really used for. I know, it probably tells me in the menus, but yeah, whatever. Picked up some loot from another little loot room inside here.
Oh, so much stuff! I'm like hungry hippos here.
Now it's time to take on the most scary cave ever. Filled with diving bell spiders. This is why it might have been a good idea to craft maybe something like a bee sting or proper, or even the little trident.
No! Where's the key? There it is! Go, 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 go!
That key is going to open up the mossy sunken chest, which has got another little chip inside, as well as again some mega milk. So back to the pond, and now a little quick fill up of health, and then through another underwater section. Digging away through the clay to get this scab, and then through to the next button. There's a whole bunch of these you've got to press to turn on the final power and get access to the main area. But first, we had these annoying little gits to deal with.
Woo! I don't remember there being quite as many. I ain't gonna lie. Oh, is he stuck in the water now?
After running around, I eventually took care of him and the one that was kind of now stuck in the water, bless him.
I'm putting you out of your misery, mate. I'm putting you out of your misery. I don't want you to live like this anymore. It's not fair.
Final tea's done, and it was time to let the light shine through the dome into the pond laboratory. Day 61 was here, and we still had a whole bunch of stuff to swim through if we wanted to complete the pond.
Let's get these super muscle... I hate Brussels sprouts. Brussels sprouts can suck your mum.
We went and got some of the resources like the sunken bone, as well as some fish scales in case we'd craft the armour later, and we went to work also on that secret little chest. This would unlock the splat burst and a few other little items. I went and explored all the other kind of dead end laboratories for now, although I think in future they will open up to different parts of the grounded map, and we explored all of the parts to get Natural Explorer. I had forgot to get this little mega milk, so we went back into the underwater section and we finished off pretty much by exiting out one of the laboratories, picking up some more resources and a brand new scab. There was just one more mega milk we had to get, which was in the tunnel here to the side of the pagoda, and then back to Burgle to give him these chips. We did also unlock curved bases, which was nice, and then it was time to explore Burgle's hole. There was a big deep one right where Burgle's laboratory is, and this would give us another couple mega milks. But there are some dangers. If you're ever running out of oxygen, make sure you kill one of these though, as they'll actually give you some precious oxygen to carry on swimming through. While we'd been delving deep, it had turned into day 62 and we got the 500 science points as well as that mega milk hiding behind the rock, once we cleared out these little dudes. Hopefully no more encounters with these guys, they're creepy as heck. Big surprise at the end of day 62.
When did I come all the way over here? Oh my god, you stay in there, mate. It doesn't look like he's disappearing either. And the, boom! Oh! Is he like literally right outside my wall? Oh my good god. Oh my god! Oh, I just called out of the corner of my eye. Get out of here, you fiend.
I tried going to sleep, but he was still there in the morning on day 63.
Did I get the katana? We did, didn't we? I've got the katana somewhere. He's dancing. He's dancing. Dance for me. Dance for me, Spidey. Oh, that's it. Oh, look, and we got the larva. He's messing as well. Shioga.
I eventually became a brave little soldier and decided to go down and face him. Mano El Spido, I think. I definitely still need to work on that perfect blocking. Absolutely loving this ladybug armor though, it definitely makes me feel unstoppable, and I haven't even started upgrading it. We also unlocked the anti-poison mutation, Mithridism, which was fantastic. I'd only just defeated that wolf spider when this ladybug larvae decided to hop onto my fence. Get off my fence! I gently encouraged him to jump like a father to his child off the side of a pool, and then quickly took him out. Day 64, we took out some roly-polies. I was desperate to start picking up more gunk, and these bad boys were probably the easiest ways to get it. And it was time to climb the picnic table once again, because I definitely needed some black ant parts and more. Up to the D&D table, and once more opening up chest, but we did have some problems with some bees. These guys were getting much more aggro from greater range now on the table. So this is the chip that's going to allow us to craft a whole bunch of the quartzite globs, and that's what we're going to need to upgrade our weapons. I was going to explore the big new honeypot and absolutely got terrorized by the bees and had to make a run for it.
Use it! Use the bomb! There we go. Ah!
The bees were certainly not happy.
It does, it's so dark and so moody. What was that about?
From one unusually angry creature to just always angry, the ant lions we took out around the sandcastle as we explored. Salt is your best weapon against these guys, but I do find that just a great big fiery sword does the trick too. Since I'd somehow ended up here, I decided to get as much salt as possible before heading home. Day 65, I got my favourite scab, Biddy Hog Horror. Also started the grind for grubs, as we was going to need a bunch of this to upgrade our armour. Day 66, we started the grind for armour upgrades. I was definitely going to get a full upgraded set before we took on the Broodmother. That was one of my targets. Could we do it? Well, let's find out. Feeling pretty epic after my first battle against the wolf spider, I went hunting for some more that I knew were around, especially in the cave under the slab. And yeah, at this point, they were pretty easy to deal with. Only if you didn't have any healing consumables at all would it be a problem if you got absolutely bit to death. And now I had Mithridism as well, it was making things a lot easier.
Yay, there we go. Got the scraps.
Sap was also becoming a bit of an issue, so that's what we did on day 68, gathering as much as we could before eventually trying to get more milk molars, especially the one that a wolf spider had been guarding for a while. The wolf spiders must have heard about my killer prowess, as this one had gone scarpers. But I did eventually find some eight-legged creatures to have some fun with. Bloodlust had gone to my head as I decided to try and mess with two wolf spiders this time, but they didn't want to play. It took 3 or 4 attempts to get their attention. Notice me! And as soon as I did, I kind of regretted it. Although we did take them out, it definitely wasn't as easy as I first thought. We'd at least moved on to the next stage of berry upgrades for our ladybug armour, and that's what we started doing on day 70, although I still needed a bunch of quartzite. So I headed over to the Trowel Cave, where I definitely knew there was a lot, but also knew there'd going to be a lot of larvae too. You do not want to go down here unless you've got some pretty decent weapons, you may get murdered by them larvae. I'll spare you any more lightsaber sound effects, but it certainly felt badass going down here, and yeah, Darth Vader absolutely with my Cortana. Eventually I got through them all, there must have been about 10 or 12 of them in here, so yeah, don't go down here unless you've got decent gear, and the reward was definitely all the quartzite. Not to mention some science points and another mega milk hidden in the little water cave here. Day 71, it was all about the berry grind. Not to mention getting it home and then drying it all on different racks. You get more berry leather doing it this way on jerky racks rather than just crafting it in the workbench. I was just about to log off for the night when we got our first raid, part of the new bug strike mechanics. The creatures were angry and they were coming for us. Turns out it was just some red ants, so they're pretty easy to take care of this time. Day 72, we spent the day in the trenches trying to get more quartzite to max upgrade our Cortana. Took care of a few of these guys, realised I'd need a tier 3 axe very soon, and got a bunch more goodies. We wouldn't have long to go before we maxed out all our milk molars and mega milks.
Jump! Beautiful.
We ended up making a little camp nearby and we cleared out the rest of the trenches before heading home and coming across this bad boy.
Oh! Oh! Come in clutch! Come in clutch! The ladybug! The ladybird! You beautiful, beautiful thing!
I'd had a hard time getting these scarabs, so I'd take all the help I could get. On the way home, I revisited our good old friend the green shield bug, and this time we made sure we got enough pieces to craft some of the new items, like having the charcoal torch and the charcoal canteen. We'd be spending a lot more time in the upyard in future, so I decided it was time to build some sort of bridge or way to get to my fort. I was saving the termite wood pile closer to the end of the 100 days, but I definitely wanted to go and get the axe. So that's pretty much what we did on day 74. Another creature that really doesn't like the salt, but certainly can still go ahead with the Cortana and do a fair amount of damage. We found enough soldiers to go ahead and get enough to make the axe, and it was time to head home. Day 75, we went and scanned some of the termite parts, and we also unlocked the repair glue. This was the new item we was going to need to repair our armors later on. So that, alongside some housekeeping, is what we did on day 76. Day 77, a little pupa hide later, and some new tough gloop, since they've changed the name from just bug gloop, and it was time to explore the upper deck. I'd heard a rumour that there were some big changes to do with the ashtray, so we skimmied our way up before eventually revealing the shocking truth. There were no more human nails inside the ashtray. It had been replaced by this metal one. Boo! There goes our dream of having a toenail weapon. Took out some dust mites and got ourselves some lint, and then it was on to the last mega milks that were up here. Climb this pot plant and then go all the way up to the top of this burr weeds, not forgetting to also pick up some of the burr. Cheeky little 500 science points, and you're in the perfect spot to jump onto the next plant pot, which is going to give you the mega milk. If you do it just right, you should make it, as long as obviously you've got a tuft. And then it was back home before the night was over, setting up our factory once more and getting some spinners to start spinning our limp rope again. Day 78, we needed some more resources from some of the bugs, mainly bug loot, so we killed a few roly-polies, and I got my ass handed to me by a couple of these ladybird larvae. Clearly, I wasn't ready for their sizzle. Of course, I had to go back for my revenge. This time I had the right weapon, and we crafted ourselves the new ever charcoal torch, and then started to go and explore just towards the evening when this happened.
Did that one, like super. Whoa! Whoa! What happened there?
Rip. Finished the night off by getting some more food resources from the anthill and more quartzite. Day 79, I had more trouble with bugs, this time mosquitoes.
Oh my god. Don't. Stop. Reload. Oh my god, the stam. Come on. What the hell? I'm getting absolutely owned here. Oh my god, I'm just getting just ruined. Absolutely ruined. I wasn't ready for this. Come on, where's my stam? Good god. Because I'm absolutely having a war with mosquitoes.
Again, having the right weapon to hand is so crucial. We finally got going a bit more with the salt mace.
Oh, yeah, suck on that.
Put my salty mace in your mouth and suck them. Yeah, moving swiftly on, we peaked some more creatures and I was starting to build up a nice supply of bug parts. We did have to go back home though and venture out again, as I already had just way too little healing stuffs. It was time to go back into the trash zone and the Black Ant Hill. So yeah, I had to do the Black Ant Hill chip as well once more. It kind of was annoying that I had to redo some of these areas, but it did give me a chance to really go at it with some new gear, and I picked up a whole bunch of tips on the way. And it did mean that this 100 days got a little bit more filled with content. I'll spare you the back and forth though, just know that I got all of the chips and we took out all of the Taze T's and Russ R's, and then managed to get through to the assistant manager boss fight without too many problems. Assistant manager can absolutely kiss my butt. He was a lot easier this time, although yeah, still a challenge. I definitely had much better armor, better weapons, and certainly a lot better healing stuff on me. So it wasn't long before we took him out. I really do hope they make all of these boss fights more replayable. It is good to come back here and try different techniques with new weapons and gear. Having peaked him, I had a nice little collection, and that brought us to day 80, which was mostly me running around the sandbox through the Black Ant Hill tunnel and just picking up loads of resources to make globs. We hadn't fully explored all these tunnels the first time we was in here, so it was a good time now to go back and pick up more quartzite too. Of course, it's the location of one of the mixers, but that'll be left for the next 100 days. And before you knew it, we had stacks and stacks of quartzite, salt, and spicy cha-chas. Day 81, it was all about the grind and also some rewards. I bought the mint mace from Burgle, and that meant we had pretty much all of the decent tiered weapons. We only need to get the Broodmother weapon now, and we were solid. Armor, the perk, getting more extra healing items instead of bulky, I feel like it's a winner. I got my chance to try some of it out on day 88 as we had another raid from the ants, and this time they were a little bit more organized. Well, maybe not these kind of dumbos down here. It turns out some of them did manage to get through the other side of my fence, and it took me like 10 years to realize, but they demolished my little bridge walkway up to the upper yard.
Come on, jump! I dare ya! Bosh! Get out of here. Oh, they destroyed my tower. Oh my god, I've only just realized. Oh no, son of a gits.
So after that incursion, I decided I needed to upgrade. So I built up another couple of levels, or at least one more, with mushroom bricks, another new staircase to get up on top of the roof, and eventually another clover walkway, so we would have another level. And that's how we finished off day 88, gathering resources and building up more of the base. I rebuilt my bridge to be stronger, faster and better, and maybe a little bit bigger. And we put a watchtower around the entrance to the upper yard this time. Day 90, it was another run through the trenches to get resources, and I decided to finish off some stuff I hadn't, like the wolf spider den pretty much underneath the big rake.
Too easy! You don't know! You can't handle my spiciness!
As well as the orb weaver that was guarding poor little Hammy. You gotta say sometimes, the grounded looks amazing. The latest update really did just turn it up 10 times fold with the lighting. And we got one of the last scabs. I pretty much have every other single one now, more or less. Man, these guys just don't want me to leave. I'm such a party animal. We took him out with the spicy sword once more. Super duper easy. And that gave us stage 3 Mithridism. We were now 75% resistant to poison. I had a little trouble with some infected gnats. I just about managed to recover my sword before slicing and dicing them to their doom. Day 91, I decided to spruce up the base a little with some trophies to put some of the dead weapons that we weren't going to be using much more. And as much as I could, I upgraded all of the most important tools and weapons. We also had a rejig, making good use of the new level to have all my armour and my bed on one, and then have a decent crafting area right at the bottom. We rearranged all of my storage as well. Finally, everything was in a nice and much easier place to get hold of it. And then a quick cook to end day 91 before day 92, finally venturing over to the termite woodpile. Turns out assault mace is absolutely OP when taking on these guys, although I think slashing is probably one of the better weapons, but the mace was still doing a good job. And I kind of decided we'd have to do this in two runs, one to clear out the areas above and get some of the best resources from the termites, and then eventually we would go back into the termite woodpile itself and clear it all out and course take on the termite king. This area was much tougher and I was quite enjoying the challenge against all the termites, the mosquitoes and of course all the wolf spiders. And I wasn't afraid to use my range gear. I'd actually set this one up properly just to see how good it would be with the archery cap and some decent arrows. And yeah, it does a good job. But nothing still beats getting up close and personal with the right weapon and going a bit melee mad. We'd have time for that though once I got up to the top of the tarpaulin. If there is any more annoying creature than the mosquitoes, do please let me know. That's definitely going to be in my top 5 video coming soon. What are the most annoying creatures? I got kind of lucky with this wolf spider. It wasn't doing me any damage as it was stuck under the tarpaulin, but I could go ahead and mash its legs up. Physics in games, go figure. I was pretty chock-a-block with resources. We had a whole bunch of materials from the mosquitoes, absolute buckets of wooden splinters, and pretty much taking me all night. So we went back and that's what we did, dumping our stuff on day 93 and then heading back to the termite hill. This time there'd be no turning back. It was time to go all the way through. We missed an opportunity, one of them guys, and we carried on exploring the tunnels while climbing the way up. I was still trying to persist with this kind of ranger class and it was doing okay for some of the termites that I come across, but in the end I did have to switch to a decent weapon, or in this case just a termite axe. There are so many of these acid throwing little white amoeba guys in here, but we pretty much managed to clear the whole hive out before going and getting some more of the resources deep in the burrow. An almost OP way to go and get a huge amount of resources, including wooden splinters and mushroom chunks. And sadly I was left with sawdust as the most current scab. Ooh. It was finally time to take on royalty and see if this king was going to give up his crown. We definitely needed some heavy artillery and I actually went with some super gas arrows. First taking out some of his minions by lowering them down. Before the main guy came along, it was this point I knew I'd messed up with this build, so I quickly run and kind of cheesed him once more. I just about made it though, as he pretty much done me a lot of damage. I promise one day I'll do like 100 days with no ranged weapons, just to show that I can actually play this game without cheesing. But is it really a cheese? Now the creatures have got super duper AI, I feel like it is a legitimate playstyle. But we've done the job, I had enough now with the termite king pieces carapace to go ahead and make the termite armour eventually. We got the last mega milk in here and that was pretty much the last one I think on the map, and the other chip. Quickly went home and made the termite armor. Day 94, we were so close to getting the final upgrades. I went and bought the advanced quartzite jewels. Now we could finally do it. I just needed to go and get some more of the green little scarabs. I did really want to get my spicy Cortana max upgraded, so we just needed that final push to get 10 of these. It turned into a bit of a saga. I just could not get these guys for love nor money. So many of them were escaping, my aim was just terrible, and yeah, they were giving me the runaround. I'd heard as well that if you had at least an upgrade of level 6 and maybe a decent splinter arrow, you should be able to take care of them. But it seems to be some glitch sometimes when you shoot them a second time, they don't actually take any damage. And of course, this little bugger did burrow in just as he was about to die. Day 95, I took a little break and we went exploring the rest of the yard, realizing that the infected spiders had kind of gone everywhere. I couldn't even get into the oak lab just to go and see if there was anything else I kind of missed buying. I was also still on the grind for lots of quartzite too.
Oh, yeah, he's not stuck now. He's not stuck. No! Oh my god! Whoa, oh my god! Run! Run! That was awful.
I remember there was still one spider den I hadn't cleared out for a while, and that was near the stone slabs up to the barbecue grill. And again, super easy peasy, especially with my like level 8 Cortana. We were so close, yet still so far. I kept on the quartzite grind for the rest of the day before eventually getting a whole bunch to take home. Day 96, and the rest of the day was really trying to get as many of the scarabs as possible. Starting with, again, the one that spawns just by the fertilizer bag and the green shield bug, where it still took a whole bunch of arrows as it, once again, it managed to ignore my second one. And then I remembered there was like at least 5 of them in a bag in the woodpile, so I quickly went over and that definitely helped. I was now at this point literally like one away from fully upgrading the Cortana, and that's what we spent the most of day 97 trying to do. That is before I got raided by a whole bunch of spiders.
You shall not pass! Oh my god, no, spiders! What? It's war, it's spiders!
This ended up being quite a lot of fun. With all the little mini orb weavers and the larger ones, it was definitely a challenge. But it's true, once you get Mithridism stage 3, it becomes a lot easier. So that is probably one negative from building, I think, a base close to here, that they may come and attack here, but it probably was more down to me taking on so many wolf spiders as I've been exploring. And yeah, it's no joke. So I can see it, I saw a lot of people complaining about the base raids, with spiders especially, and now I realise how much that could really mess you up if your base was in the wrong position. Luckily, mine seemed to be almost perfect. Well, I say almost, there was one slight defect. I'd forgotten that my little walkway that I'd been using to get up to my base, well, that was on the ground level next to the Frankenlion, and of course the little spider buggers had discovered and destroyed it. So we'll have to work on that in the future. I still had a job to do before the end of the day, and that was to get hold of a scarab. But my luck just sucked big time.
It's got to have worked. It was dead.
Oh, no way! No way! I was cutting it close, I'd aimed to take on the Broodmother by day 99, but I needed this final one, and eventually I got there even with my dodgy aim. So pretty much the whole of day 98 was spent getting more quartzite to make the final quartzite jewel. But we did it, we finally did it. Max upgrade armor for now, max upgraded weapon. It was time to go and face the Broodmother. I loaded up a chest with some consumables, some spare armour and weapons, and we made the big massive trek all the way over to the hedge. Turns out to be quite a long journey with multiple ants and other creatures stopping us in our tracks, but eventually we did make it. And yes, I know, I didn't need to make all them BLTs, I thought I needed every single one, but I forgot you get the BLT back if you haven't defeated it. One final check of my mutations to make sure I had the right stuff on, and it was time to take on the Broodmother.
It's in! It's in! It's in! A few shots in as soon as it comes down. That's it. And then switch. Oh! Oh! Okay, deal with the ads. Oh, it's, oh my god, this is amazing. Oh, what the hell was that? Come on. Don't panic, Jade. Don't panic. Oh, it's done me again. Oh. Run to the other side! Run! Run, stalking me! No! Run! Come on! Ah! Oh! Come on! That's it. Oh. Heal me, heal me, heal me, heal me, heal me. Come on! Oh, it's four of them! Run, 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 run. Oh no, I did not defend there. I did not defend. Quick. Oh! Come on! Yes! I'm going for it! I'm going for it! I'm going for it! Oh, it's stopping me yeeing or so. Oh no! Not that one! Come on! Just gotta keep running around, away from it, away from it, away from it. No! Oh, I'm gonna die! Oh! The aphid coming in clutch! Come on! Yes! Yes! Woo! Get in! I did it! Oh my god, that was so tough! Oh! Oh look, I used up every heal! Every single one of them! Woo! Oh baby, ah, piece of cake, piece of cake. Ah, do you know what though, I just realised I never peeped the brood mother. No, oh no, I never peeped it. Oh, I'm gutted.
There was only one thing left to do. I'd head back to the chest, replen whatever else was left, and hopefully defeat it a second time in succession. Well, since I defeated it once, I wasn't too fussed or worried, and at this point I really didn't have many heals at all. But I did manage to peep it, I just didn't get the gold version, so that'll have to be for another 100 days. Also, please, Obsidian, change what button it is to use a shield and throw bombs or drop them.
Oh! Okay, I don't think that worked. Oh! Oh, it's just, it's almost impossible. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Maybe we could shoot one of them. Oh, no! No, that went wrong. That went so wrong. That went so wrong. Oh. That's it. I've got to sleep.
So, success, but a little sadness. Anyhow, we managed to go back to home and we crafted the Mask of the Mother Demon, and then we made sure we also got, obviously, the Club of the Mother Demon too. It'd been an emotional 100 days. The first 50, obviously, getting me reacquainted with the game after not playing it legit for a long time, and now we had some big targets in mind. We're gonna carry on, either 150 days, maybe even just straight up to 200 days. We'll see if we can defeat all the mixers, get as many gold cards as possible, and make sure we got lots of bases, as well as other things like get some pets. And who knows, there may be a little update in store before the full release of the game comes out and we start all over again, fresh, brand new 100 days experience. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you do, please leave a like, leave a comment what your favourite bit was, and leave me some challenges for the next 100 days. Until next time, Ratbags, I will see you later.